We have a very specific syntax for specifying timestamps in Pi, and the most definitive word about that you'll find in this Pi Server 2010 system management guide. You can download that from our tech support site, as you can see right here. There also is a copy that should be with the computer-based training in the class materials. And as you can see, we go into great detail about how this format works, this time format works. Let me go ahead and just demonstrate what we're talking about here. We have a specific absolute time that involves day, month, year, hour, minute, second. So for example, if I'm interested in the 30th of January, 2011 at 7 o'clock, I specify it like that, day, month, year, hour, minute, second. Now most of our clients are also, they're also able to recognize a Windows time format. So I can go all the way down to the second there. Yeah, so in addition to doing it this way, you can also use a Windows format for most of our clients. But this is the standard Pi syntax that you'll use for timestamp that you'll find will work with almost all of our utilities. Now, in addition to this absolute, the absolute reference that you see here, we also have a relative reference in which you can, instead of specifying hard-coded names of times or specific times, you can just say, oh, let me see the last 8 hours. We'll take a look at that in just a second. Now, one more point I wanted to make about this time syntax, though, is if I leave parts of this off, so for example, I leave off the hour, you'll notice right now we start at, this is the first value after 7 a.m., but watch what happens when I leave the hour off. I go ahead and refresh this. It's actually now finding the first value after midnight. So the rule here is if you leave off the hour, it's going to default to midnight. Now let me show you what happens if you leave off the day. I'm going to just choose 7 o'clock to, let's go to, how about 10 o'clock? So I've left off the hour or the year, month, and day. When I do that, it's going to default to whatever the current is. So in this case, it's the 31st of January, and I'm seeing from 7 to 10. So, you know, and all variations in between. If I were to say, let's say the 25th or 25 space, okay, what that's actually doing is I'm leaving off the year and the month, so it's defaulting to the current year and current month. So to demonstrate, I'll go ahead and retrieve that. As you can see, it's finding the first value after the 25th. It's actually the 27th. It's kind of a bad example. Let me show you the 28th. Yeah, so I'm specifying the 28th with, let's just go with no hour, minute, or second. So by choosing 28, we're assuming the current year, current month. And as you can see, that starts off midnight as of the 28th. And if I were to specify an hour, let's go with 9 o'clock like that. Now it's the first value after the 28th at 9 o'clock. So that's the rule of thumb. Now, we have this relative time that I mentioned also. And the relative time would be to specify, for example, asterisk minus 8 hours, which means the current time minus 8 hours. And I'll specify as my end time the current time, asterisk. So asterisk is the reserved word or the reserved character that indicates current time. If I refresh this, this is simply going back 8 hours from the current time. And in addition to hours, I can do D for day. We specify M for minute. There's W for weeks, Y for years, MO for months. So those are the, you know, the legal or the allowable abbreviations here. So if I do 15M, this is just the last 15 minutes, which may or may not bring back anything there. There we go. Now, in addition, we have some reserved words for days of the week. So for example, if I'm just interested in what happened from Saturday to what happened on Monday, that's going to assume the current, zero for the rest of the timestamp. So Saturday is the most recent Saturday. Monday is the most recent Monday, and that's going to be at midnight on each of those. So we're seeing the first value after Saturday at midnight, all the way up to the last value before Monday at midnight, which would be, that would be Sunday at close to midnight. Two more abbreviations that I think you'll find very, very useful. You can use Y to stand for yesterday and T to stand for today. So Y as the start time, T for the end time, gives me yesterday at midnight to today at midnight. And if I were to go, let's go with this yesterday's day shift, Y plus 7H, that's yesterday plus 7 hours, we'll go with Y plus 15 hours, that's 7 to 3. Yeah, that's going to return for me 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. yesterday.